Mogadishu's K5 intersection is normally teeming with people buying and selling everything from food, clothing and water to foreign currency and cat, a mild narcotic leaf. But it was quiet on Sunday when emergency workers were still cleaning blood from streets and buildings. Twinkle bomb explosions near a busy junction in Somalia's capital, Mogadishu, killed at least 100 people. President Hassan Sheikh Mohamud says among the victims who were massacred were mothers with their children. He appealed for international medical help to deal with 300 injured. The president blamed the Al-Shabaab militant group for Saturday's attack, which targeted the education ministry. The pro-jihadist Somali Memo website has reported that the group has said it was behind the blasts. President Mohamud, in power for 5 months, pledged total war against the Islamic militants after they attacked a popular hotel in Mogadishu in August, killing at least 21 people.
Who were these victims? Somali people who are recovering from the attacks 5 years ago in the same area. Some of them recovered from injuries, some were disabled, some were orphans who lost their loved relatives in previous attacks, and others.
Saturday's blasts happened within minutes of each other, destroying buildings and vehicles in the vicinity. The first hit the education ministry, and then the second went off as medical teams arrived to deal with the aftermath. After Saturday's attack, hundreds of people have gathered near the site looking for missing family members. President Mohamud said the bombings were a message sent by the militants to show that they are still alive, despite the fact that they were defeated in battlefield by government forces. The African Union mission in Somalia said that the attacks underlined the urgency and critical importance of the ongoing military offensive to further degrade Al-Shabaab. The US, Turkey, Qatar and Germany have all condemned the attack. Al-Shabaab has been battling the AU-backed federal government for control of Somalia for around 15 years. The group controls much of the southern and central Somalia, but it has also been able to extend its influence into areas controlled by the government based in Mogadishu.